the creativity that staff display will for sure do some things that are quite frankly research-based. The more innovative a staff is, the higher the productivity rate, whether that be a service delivery or product development and delivery, or quite frankly, new vertical development as well within your organization. All of that spikes when you allow people to innovate, when they can sit together, even virtually, right, on screen and have a time of ideation around a problem, sort of the latest and greatest. What are we hearing? What are our clients telling us, customers telling us? How can we solve for that? Even if it's not a problem today, could we, you know, be ahead of the curve and come up with a solution before we hear it from our customers? That's going to drive up productivity. In conjunction with that, your retention rate climbs as well, the more creative you allow a staff to be. There is an appeal to an organization that allows someone to have room to sort of spread wings and innovate. It is more than just cash, believe it or not, that keeps people at an organization. So capitalize on that in ways that really may not cost you as much as you might think. Again, this sort of forum for innovation is a way that could fit that. And you want to ask managers about how to do it best. If you come in as senior leadership and just say, now we are going to budget an hour, 2 hours in everyone's schedule every week in order for there to be innovation, and make it a chore to managers to allow their staff to have that time off each week to do that away from the regular tasks, and it is just forced on managers, you're missing it. It's going to start on a bad foot. So, you know, the way to cultivate that is to bring those folks in as well. Again, a spike to retention, because managers want to be at a place where they feel like they have input. The last thing that I'll mention in terms of a benefit is an improvement to inclusion and equity. How so? Well, you are cultivating an opportunity for diversity of thought at its most base level. You're asking people to bring something to the table. When you allow ideation, true ideation to happen, anybody can offer something to the group. And everyone has to have an opportunity to sort of unpack those ideas, regardless of socioeconomic background, regardless of race or creed, regardless of gender, regardless of these things that often are restrictive in the process. It forces people to confront any bias that they may have, because if we're really a creativity-based organization, we have to hear from everyone. There's not one person's voice who's better than another. And so by kind of forcing that foundational perspective, inclusion and equity happen, and there's a movement towards opportunity for more people, underrepresented classes of people, because of the innovative opportunities that are presented as a result of this creativity that goes on in the organization. All positives. So I would encourage you to do it. This is John Baldino, president of Humoriso.